Thank you, and mayong hapon sa tanan. Happy Sabbath. This is my second time to be here, and I'm happy to be back. No? And I find it hard to refuse my longtime classmate, no? Si Bing Bing. And this afternoon, I'm going to talk about the mental health impact of COVID-19 and focusing on resilience. No? I have given this talk to a lot of forum, and I'm happy to share this message with you this afternoon. In this time of pandemic, we need to be steadfast. No? We need to be steadfast. And to be steadfast in times of adversity is to be resilient. No? Next slide, please. So, next again. So, resilience is defined as the process of adapting well in the face of adversity. So, we have an adversity right now, no? The COVID pandemic. It's also useful in overcoming trauma, tragedy, threats, or any significant source of stress in our lives, no? So, resilience is actually a person's ability to withstand adversity, bounce back, and grow. So, hindi bala na we need to be resilient in times such as this. So, why is there a need to build resilience? No? So, like this plant, no, in the picture, it's growing in a pavement, no? So that's not the natural habitat of a plant, no? So it needs to be very, very resilient in order to survive. No? So according to David Kessler, he said that collective grief is in the air. So what do you mean by collective grief? The world has changed, no? So we have to admit that the world has changed. Why do we have to keep physical distance? Why do we need to wear a mask? Why do we have to fall in line? And every time we go to SNR, we have to wash our hands, no? So everything has changed, no? So there's a loss of normalcy, no? So una do kapos lang nga magkadto ka sa store, pagasulod mo to gwa kwaon mo baklon mo gwa ka subong mapila ka, and ang lain nga matabo kun wai patubalang imo nga ginapangita, pero 30 minutos na imo to pungko sa gwa nga pila, no? So loss of normalcy. And a lot of us have fear of economic toll. Like for example, even in our practice now, I used to hold clinic every day, no? Every day, Monday to Friday or even Saturday, pero subong 3 times a week na lang, no? Monday, Wednesday, and Friday only. So I cut my practice into half. Singuna, 6 hours a day, subong 3 hours na lang, no? So that means that I'm now earning only half of my income, no? And very difficult mag-admit sang pasyente sa ospital, no? So psychiatric ward, it used to be 10 bed, now 5 beds na lang, no? So very limited na ang ano. So that's why you may have a hard time if you get hospitalized, no? And a lot of business have declared honestly bankruptcy, no? Even Jollibee several months ago have announced na they're going to close 250 of their branches, probably temporarily, no? Pero hamak mo, you can't imagine, Jollibee, no? Jollibee, kabakal-bakal, gulpilang masabal sa Jollibee, manira sila sa iba nila ng mga stores. And famous brands like Victoria's Secret, nag-declare bankruptcy, H&M, mga Guess, mga Esprit, Gap, they decide to close some of their flagship stores and pero sige pa sila business but online, no? So nag-shift ang aton nga no. So lucky for us if you have a regular job, no, pero ang tourism industry, airline industry, hotel industry are severely affected. And loss of connection, no? We don't see each other's smile anymore, no? Even students, no, they do not see their classmates. They see their classmates on video, on Zoom, no, when they hold classes, no? So loss of connection, no? And canceling of plans. Who has plans to travel this year? No, I know many of us may have plans to travel, but because of the pandemic, canceled. No, for me and my family, we last March we were scheduled to go to the U.S. No, and our itinerary, New York. No. And 10 days before we fly, they declare lockdown, so everything is canceled. May lang na-refund ang ticket. But it's good for us to be, ano, why mo dayon? Because what would happen if we have proceeded and we have been locked down in New York, and if it is the epicenter of the COVID pandemic in the US, so grabe ng problema siguro kung ato ka to, no? So cancellation of plans, no? So stay at home na lang kita, okay man, no? There's the fear of physical danger, no? There's always the fear of being infected, no, the fear of being infected, and not only being infected, especially as health worker, but the fear of infecting our families and our loved ones, no, especially we have elderly parents or grandparents at home, no, so the fear of physical danger. And the elephant in the room is actually the fear of death, no? A lot of people have this fear of death. If you don't have assurance of salvation and if you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, then you have to fear death, no? Because you do not know where you're going, no? But we know why we are celebrating Christmas, because Jesus came to save us, no? To save us. So we do not have to fear death, actually. Next slide. So in times of this COVID pandemic, it is important, and the name of the game, I think, is survival, no? We have to survive. So therefore, in order to survive, it is vital to be resilient, no? It is vital to be resilient. This is a picture of a man with a CISO, no? On the left side are negative outcomes. Next slide, please. So, ano ang mga negative factors? Loss of job, physical distancing, no? Our schools are modular or online. Our loved ones with COVID-19. So, when we locked down last March, nag-lockdown kita, no? March, April, May, no? 2 months, no? Wala pa to. Kung ako, if I think, wala pa to yan. Because nga may insect nga nag-travel from Wuhan, nga nagkato sa Dumaguete, kato sa Cebu, napatay sa Manila, nag-lockdown kita dahil kay kinulbaan kita, no? Pero we have a very few, minimum pila lang to ka case, no? But now, no, subong, I believe if we need to be locked down, it should be now, no? Because I have seen several friends, no, na COVID. May face na yung COVID para sa ako, no? And several doctors have COVID. And we even have a scare sa rehab center where I sa rehab center namon. Out of 30 patients and 18 gid ang nagpositive. No? So grabe nga libog sa ulo ko as program director because 18 of my patients, staff and patients had COVID, no? And I'll tell you more about it later on. On the right side, we have the social amelioration program. A lot of people got 6,000 pesos from the government. Pero the one time mo lang to, no? Can the government sustain, give people 6,000 a month, no? Hindi na kita ka-quarantine, liwat, because the government cannot afford, no, the economic toll of another quarantine, no? But in spite of that, as long as we have our family, no, we have a loving relationship. My daughter has been away for 6 years, no, in college, eskwela abroad, then work in Manila, and because of the quarantine, she's now at home. So for the first time in 6 years that our family is complete, I only have one daughter actually. No? Isa lang gid. No? And it is important to develop coping skills. So, next slide. So on the left, we have negative outcomes. On the right, we have positive outcomes. And in the middle is the fulcrum. No? The fulcrum. So a fulcrum is the point where the scale balance, no? It's the balance. And everyone's fulcrum is in a different position because we are all different from each other. We have different coping styles, no? We have different ways of managing our stress, no? But the good news is the fulcrum can be moved. No? So I'll tell you how to move the fulcrum later on. So what can we do to build up and strengthen resilience? No? So what are the things that we need to do, no, in order to build resilience? So in psychiatry, I teach my student the biopsychosocial model, no? But we will add another dimension, spiritual. So actually, it's bio, psycho, social, and spiritual, no, approach. So we need to be holistic, no? So when we say biological, it has to do with our physical bodies, our anatomy, and our physiology, no? Psychological, our emotions, and our thoughts. And social, our behavior and our relationship with other people, no? And spiritual, it has to do with our relationship with God, no? So a relationship with God will give us meaning and purpose in life, no? So all of these factors should work together for us to become more resilient. Next slide. So, the first thing to do is to unload the negative side. Buhinan ta ang negative side, no? Reducing our sources of stress. So, how do we unload the negative side? So, consider your source of stress. Actually, you know what stresses us the most nowadays? It's actually social media. No, social media, because of the restrictions in information, we get a lot of information from social media, and sometimes we do not only get the right news, but we also get the fake news. No? And the fake news irritates us. No? Irritates us. And nowadays, I no longer listen to the news. No? I did an experiment once. No? Every morning when I wake up, I drink coffee. And when I drink coffee, ang akon nga maid would listen to Bombo Radio. No? So, tiga, inom ko da kape, pamati. Tiga, ara ang Bombo Radio. Tiga, mabatian ko man ang Bombo Radio. Kaya, gainit ang ulo ko kung may inefficiency sa government, o may palpak na naman, o may ano. So, sabi ko sa maid ko, Kat, why don't patyabla ang imo radyo? Dali lang gid. So, gin pataya ang radyo. Di siling ko, hindi bala nagtauhay balay ta. Okay, naghipos gulpe. Kung may kita ito labot sa problema sa guwa, tauhay ato niya balay ho. So, because the negative news actually affects us. So I, siguro kung isa, gascan-scan na lang ko mga headlines, but I do not really read the news much anymore. So be realistic. Set limits on your available resources. So we have limited time. Even our financials might have been affected, no? So, since March to November, I have not bought any shirt, any pants. Birthday ko August, so this was a gift from my wife, but I did not buy any anything. Sa una ka, after clinic, malagaw-lagaw ka sa SM, magkita ka, ay, sale, ang 1,500 na lang. So it's so easy to buy things. And I discovered sa akon nga aparador, kadamo patugali sa mga bayo, nga gin pang stock ko, may mga tag pa. No? Why gadya gali magamit? So now, since nga, why na ko nag-shopping, why na ko bakal, amat-amat ko ito pang gamit, ang mga nakastock pa. So we have to, most of our shopping goes to groceries, no? Groceries, kag hardware siguro, kung may mga guba-guba na sa balay, no? So consider whether social media is adding unnecessary drama to your life, no? So you have to gauge that for yourself, no? Kung isa may mga basher, no? Mag-post ka pala, may mga basher. Better na lang hindi, no? So, in other words, the point is to avoid toxic environment. Avoid situations that add unnecessary stress to your life. Okay? Overcome fear with actual facts. No? So, every year, since 500,000 people die of flu. Pero why ito nag-lockdown, no? Every year, ang seasonal flu, every year. May flu shots naman, may flu vaccine, pero every year, we need a new flu shots because the virus mutates, no? So 500,000 actually die every year. COVID is more virulent than, I thought I corrected the slides, but ang what the point that I go back one first slide, please. Okay, the point is we are so afraid of dying of COVID. In fact, more than 1 million have died of COVID. I think the latest data is 1.6 million has already died worldwide, no? 1.6. But compare that, 1.6, compare that to accidents and injuries, no? 5.8 million die of accidents and injuries every year. And cancer kills 9.6 million every year. And cardiovascular disease kills 17.9 million, at least 18 million people die every year because of cardiovascular disease like heart attack or stroke. No? So meaning to say, your chances of dying of a cardiovascular disease is much, much higher compared to your chance of dying of COVID. Diba? So you should fear more cardiovascular disease than COVID. No? Next slide, please. So a pandemic is not new to us. No, this is not the first time that we have. Pero through years ago, no, we have pandemics, no. Most recent amunisya, no, the Russian flu in 1889 killed about a million people. The Spanish flu was the worst. This was after World War I, no. 1917 to 1919, it killed actually 50 million people worldwide. So it killed around half of the Philippine population probably. No? Kung amuna siya, no? 50 million people. So, see? Asian flu followed Hong Kong flu, Russian flu, so SARS. No? SARS. So we worry about pandemics, but as you can see also correlate yung ang world population. In 1889, there's only 1.5 billion people on earth. Sa nag-Spanish flu, 1.8 billion people on earth. Sa Subong, there is now 7.8 billion people on earth. So, what do we mean by that? No? Throughout the century, the human race continued to flourish, no? Continued to thrive despite pandemics. No? Maminusan 1 million, maminusan 50 million, and the human race the human population continues to increase. No? So, the pandemics in the past has not wiped out the human population. In fact, the human population continued to increase despite of pandemic. We are now 7.8 billion no? People on earth. And around 1.6 million has died because of the COVID pandemic. Next slide, please. So this is now the current, no? This is now the current. I check this is the as of yesterday. Total global case is 75,672,759 people have already been infected with COVID. And total death is about 1.6 million, no? 674,838. So about 1.6 million people have already died. But I would like to emphasize on the recovery rate. No, we are so hala kada 1.6 na million people have died. But although 75 million have been infected, 97 to 99% recover. No? 97 to 99% recover. I said na 18 of my staff and patients sa rehab had COVID, and most of them mild symptoms lang, no? Mild symptoms lang, fever, some difficulty of breathing, body malay. Ang worst gid siguro nga symptoms ng COVID is loss of taste, no? Loss of taste because food will taste like paper, no? Food becomes tasteless, no? So ang pinanamon ka worst nga na infect, only one who needs to have oxygen, but the rest recovered uneventful, no? Uneventful. So 97 to 99%. In fact, all the 18 nga ng COVID sa rehab recovered. Sa St. Paul's man, na-lockdown kami last time, no? 11 doctors were diagnosed to be positive with COVID, and all recovered, no? All recovered. So 99% ang recovery. Who are those 1% nga nagakapatay? Those who are actually immunocompromised, no? Those who have already comorbid illness, like those who have cancer, those who have a heart ailment, those who have pulmonary problems, those who are immunocompromised. No? So these are most likely the elderly population. But there are those may young people who also died with COVID. Next slide, please. So although we may worry, but we should not really worry too much about COVID. No, 97 to 99% chance is you're going to recover. Okay. So next thing to do is to load up on the positive side. No, so we need to add more weight on the positive side. So. How do we do that? Focus on the positive things, on how you can maximize them. So what are the positive things? As of now, we know that the sunlight is still free. So we need to, don't lock yourself in the room. You need to go out, no? Enjoy the sunshine. No? So ako, I get my dose of sunshine every Sunday for 4 hours. Oh, because I play golf in Santa Barbara, no? So once a week lang, so every Sunday for 4 hours. So healthy lifestyle. I know na this church has no problem with healthy lifestyle, because the Seventh Day Adventist has been known to be an advocate of healthy lifestyle, no? In fact, ang inyong insurance rate dapat policy dapat nubo ang inyong rate, kay you are all healthy, no? Because you practice the dietary restrictions of the scriptures, and you follow a healthy lifestyle. So I don't have to tell you about healthy lifestyle, but I know you eat right, no? And we also need to sleep at least 6 to 8 hours a day. So, some nagasagad pa ka internet kung gabi, nagasurfing, nagapulaw, no, nagagaming, no. So we need at least 6 to 8 hours of sleep a day, no, in order to build our resistance. What else? Exercise, no. We need exercise. I had an accident August, because I bought a new skateboard. And I was trying to remember how I used to ride the skateboard when I was in high school. So abi ko high school po ko gihapon. Galing kay 55 na galing edad ko, no? So kaya ko sa skateboard, you know, kaya ko na lampos ako na hips, kaya ako shoulder. Actually, I had frozen shoulder, and my hips were affected. And I cannot walk for 2 days. No? I cannot walk for 2 days. And my wife has to spoon feed me. No? Nilahungit na lang ko ni Charmaine kaya hindi ako kumangon. But on the third day, no, just like Jesus, I said I have to force myself to stand, force myself to go to the dining table, force myself to go to the CR. And I started exercising. May arap to stationary bike sa balay. May arap mo to elliptical walker, and it became a regular thing. No, sin ko nagkala ano lang kali ni nagkala nagkala yabokan lang kay why ko gidagabit. So I started using it, and I rehabilitated myself. No, and I'm glad I'm doing it now. Naghalalog na mga pantalon ko. Kung siya nagkakawagak mga pantalon ko. So, it's good to lose weight actually, and to maintain a healthy lifestyle. No? So, I'm still learning. No? Why pa ma-perfect? Hopefully, strengthen relationships. No? Strengthen the relationship, especially with our family. No? use time to your advantage. So if we work from home or we there's another lockdown, we should use the time to read our books. There are a lot of things that we would like to do, no? And we should use our time wisely. Sa mga students, kung ano, just continue reading your textbook, no? And ano. And we are to take precautionary measures, no? So si Trump kay wa siya nag-mask kundi na infection, no? So we need to wear our mask, we need to wash our hands, and we need to keep a physical distance. So when it's too crowded, so you refrain from going to crowded places. Kung ato ka to sa tunga uma, sino ma-infect sa imo to? Kung ato ka to sa tunga bits, sino ma-infect sa imo to? Pero kung magkato ka, tanaw ka sine, attend ka parties, no? So chances are you might get infected. I did not know that one of my staff was infected, and I had breakfast with that staff, no? Ang index case, nag-breakfast pa kami. I think on a Tuesday, then pagka Friday, positive siya. So I have to declare also self-quarantine to myself, no? And fortunately, my RT-PCR turned out negative, no? So I'm glad nga why. So practice lang sang aton nga ano, no? And continue to take precautions. So next is, we are told, pirmi nga, social distancing. Di ba? Social distancing. You have heard that over and over again. But actually, that's a wrong term. It's actually physical distancing, not social distancing. What do you mean by that? Kung physical distancing, 1 meter or 6 feet, no? Apart, no? But actually, we should stay socially connected, no? What do you feel nga isa-isa kalanda? Why ka istoryahon, no? Di ba daw, ano ka daw, malalain ka? I remember my cousin was hired by a New York broadcaster na mabantay sang iabalay sa New Jersey, bala mo. No? So, siya lang na isa nabilin. Nami-nami isang balay, high-tech, kumplito, may swimming pool, may ano. Pero isa lang siya to. Tignan mo, masinggit siya. Kung ano siya nga. Primero, enjoy siya. Oh, grabe, naminami isang balay. Pero simuli, isa-isa ka lang tugali. Grabe nga, boredom, no? So, nag-resign siya. Tawahay-tawahay nga obra, pero nagalin siya kay do priso ka, why ka obra hon, no? Why ka istorya hon? So, that's why we need to stay socially connected. We need to see each other face to face, but we have discovered now that through our phones, no, Skype, no, iPad, Viber, Zoom, Messenger, we can talk to our friends. In fact, I talked to Bingbing a while ago that tomorrow morning we're going to have a barkada reunion. So my classmates from UP High School, we're going to have a barkada reunion. And 6 of these classmates are living in the United States, no? And we can talk to each other through Zoom, no? And even our classes are Zoom. So you can organize family groups. So may messenger group man ko sa mga utod ko, contact ko sa mga cousins ko, mga friends ko sa abroad, no? So actually, we can stay socially connected through our cell phone, through our iPad, through our computer, no? So in fact, ang wife ko 30 years na nga wise lang kita sa mga classmates niya sa US, and now they're having monthly reunion, no? every month may reunion sila. So sino na member sa mga garden club, no? Our family, my wife and daughter, decided to take up gardening. So napuno na sa tanong mga amon nga balay, no? So so it's interesting, no? To te ako nagapang water, nako plant kadaaga. No? So, continue to exercise, to sing, join prayer groups. No, we continue to hold Bible studies online. Share updates, jokes, recipes, pictures, poems with friends. So, kuya, if I find anything funny or anything uplifting, anything that is praiseworthy, I send it to my friends. No. To encourage them, no, especially kung pate-pate ko kadlaw, no, so that they can also laugh, no. And ano ganun natin kayo na, a merry heart, no, is good medicine, no, but broken spirit dries up the bones, no? So share jokes, no, wholesome nga jokes, ha. So it is also important to renew the mind, no? To renew the mind. So there are useful worries and useless worries. So you should categorize, no? Useful worry is when you worry about real problem. Useless worry is when you worry about hypothetical situation. No? Mga basi-basi bala, no? Kung anong matabo, kung ano. Di ba si hindi pakaabot ang vaccine o muna, no? So that's useless worry. Mas ma-worry ka kung crowded ang ano, ang SNR o crowded ang SM, kaya you don't know, no? People might be infected. So you should refrain from going to crowded places. So next slide, please. Strengthen social support by connecting with people who are positive. There are people who are negative. In the hospital, we call them toxic people. No? So people who are more positive appreciate and express kindness. They enjoy every moment. They relive positive experiences. So, you know, when you talk to your friends, no, I'm sure tomorrow when I talk to my high school friends, we're going to relive high school experiences, no, when we grew up together. Express gratefulness and focus on the positive side of the story and messages. So, actually, connect with people who are positive. Connect with people in the church, no? Because it actually describes a Christian or a believer. No? So a Christian or a believer should be more positive. No? Rather, should be more positive. Should be more optimistic. No? Compared to people of the world. No? So relate more with your brothers and sisters or fellow Christians, because these are the categories of a believer, actually, characteristics of a believer. Move the fulcrum. So we reduce stress, no? But now we have to move the fulcrum. So how do we remove the fulcrum? To move the fulcrum is we have to renew the mind. In the blah, Romans 12, 1, ano na, 1 and 2. Oh. So we are told to renew the mind. No? So rather than think of negative things, we should think more of positive things. No? So in cognitive therapy, we call that alternative thoughts. No? Alternative thoughts. Ikaw na gid ang pinaka unfortunate nga person in the world. So actually, you're not the most unfortunate person in the world because God loves you and Christ died for you. No? Actually, plangga ka sa Diyos. So if you believe that God loves you, God will provide for you, God will take care of you, so you won't be afraid. So we have to change our minds. We have to agree with the scriptures. No? We have to claim the promises of God. No? So actually, everything has been given to us. All spiritual blessings has been given to us. And all we have to do is to claim it by faith. No? Claim it by faith. When we go to SM, when we buy things, we pay money. Or we take out our credit card. But with regards to everything that has been promised to us, all the spiritual blessing, we have to claim it by faith, no? By faith. So we have to renew the mind. And we have to also to be kind to yourself. To nano, choose your battles. Ako, I decided my last clinic was yesterday. So because I've been holding clinic from January up to yesterday, so I'm actually very tired, no? Kapoy na ko, so I need also a break, no? So we all do. So take a break, no? Choose your battles, no? Be grateful, no? Be grateful. We have to be grateful to the Lord that we're still alive, that we can meet together, no? An attitude of gratefulness. Maintain hope, no? Maintain hope. The last thing that we should take away is hope, because we actually have this blessed hope in the Lord, no? We have this blessed hope. And sitting ni Paul, and the greatest of this is love, no? Love. So to love God and to love one another. So it's really the different mindset, no? Putting God's word into practice, no? So you have to find your compass and purpose in life, no? So if you're a Christian, if you're a believer in the Lord Jesus, you know you have a compass and you have a purpose. You have a purpose in life. So find your purpose and compass in life, no? So a compass is supposed to give us direction, while an anchor keeps the ship steady, no? Keep the ship steady. So we need a compass and an anchor in life. So do you know your purpose in life? We can only know our purpose if we have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, no? So do you have a dependable compass? Kasi some of you may not no longer know what a compass is, but you know GPS, no? Waze or Google Earth or Google Map, no? So do you know where to dock and where to cast your anchor should the storms arise? So we know that in life, it's not always sunshine, no? Rain must fall. In fact, in the Philippines, we have how many typhoons a year? At least 20, no? Sometimes 24, or sometimes all alphabet na ubos na, no? A to Z. So subong Viki, no? We are letter V, no? There's a storm, that's why it's been raining, no? So expect that, no? And amidst all this, biskan mag-ulan, mainit, mabagyo, we are able to stand because of our faith, no? Because of our faith. And when we put God's word into practice. So let go. Kung ano man ang aton nga problema, aton nga fears, ang aton nga worries, we need to let go. So what do we let go? Let go of what I cannot control. So there are things that you cannot control. You cannot control the self-care of other people, if they wash their hands or not, the activities of other people, they want to have Christmas parties, or they want to have they want to go drinking, the attitude of other people, the duration of the COVID pandemic, we do not know if next year ara pa siya, no? The government response, which is quite inefficient, and that drives me mad actually, or irritates me, no? The news, so that's why there's a lot of fake news. So when it comes to COVID, I go to reliable sources, like sa mga med students, you go to Johns Hopkins University, no? So I go to Johns Hopkins website because I know that they produce reliable, so my figures are actually taken from Johns Hopkins. reliable news. So the response and reaction of others, we do not even know what will happen in the future. No? So what should we focus? Focus on my self-care. So we take care of ourselves, we wear our masks, we wash our hands, we diet and we exercise. My activities, no, we can control our activities. We need to rest, we need to work. My time, especially my attitude, no, to maintain a more positive attitude, no, a more optimistic attitude. So, ano aton attitude nga, ano, this thing will pass, no? Ang pandemic in the past did not last more than, ano, 5 years, no? Or some did not last more than 1 year or 2 years. So this thing will pass. Ang SARS to sa no, grabe kulba ta to, hindi ba? Di, nalipat na kita nga may SARS ka na a few years ago. So our attitude, we can control our attitude, my response, my focus, and importantly, my faith. No, my faith. So we have to walk by faith and not by sight. Hindi ba? And the righteous will live by faith. No? So we live by faith. So let go and let God. Actually, amo na ang message. Let go and let God. Let go of our worries and our fears and trust God. No? Si Solomon, the wisest man who ever lives, gives us this advice in Proverbs. Yeah, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not in your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. No? So we memorize this scripture because it tells us to trust in the Lord. No? Trust in the Lord. The problem is bigger than ourselves. Anong pagka, ano, 75 million people has already been infected worldwide. So this is big. No? This is called a worldwide pandemic. So we need a bigger God, no? So we need a power bigger than ourselves, and we should turn to God so we can always trust God, because actually, ang bottom line, He loves us so much. No? And si David, the father of King Solomon, wrote in Psalm, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. No? God is our refuge. Nandumduman yung ako maglain pa matyag mo o may malain nga natabo sa imo. Kay sino ka nagakadto? Sang gamay ka pa? Kay nanay, no? Kay mama. Kay... So we run to mama every time we get into trouble. No? Biskang gani, gamedicine ka, kung siya tawag ka pa kay mama mo, ibibi ka da, kay fail ka sa exam mo. So you run to mama. So instead of running to mama, we run to God. No? He is our refuge and our strength. He is the ever-present help in trouble. So last month, I was in trouble. Ambal ko, I had 18 staff and patients who were COVID positive, and I di ko katulog gabi, panumdom, no? The burden of responsibility because I was the program director. So I go to God in prayer, galuhod man ko kag Lord, tugyan mo ni sa imo kay dako din kayo nga problema para sa ako. And in fact, the Lord rescued us. The Lord has been merciful to us. Everyone survived, no? Have not I commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. This is the instruction given to Joshua before they entered the promised land. No? So they were supposed to conquer the promised land. And God repeated it 3 times. No? Be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. Be strong and very courageous. No? So this should be our attitude in times as this. No? This is how we can become resilient. We have to be strong and courageous in times just this. We have to trust God. And the bottom line is, because the Lord is with us. No? No, the Lord is with us. It is the presence of of the Lord. David was able to kill Goliath because of the presence of the Lord in him. So how do we know that we are resilient? Proof of resilience? We have an appreciation of life. We appreciate life more. Ako, every time a person close to me dies, so I appreciate life more. Last week, a classmate of ours died of ketoacidosis, a very reversible illness. He could have been saved if he went to the hospital early or he was brought to the hospital early, but he died at the age of 55. And I heard the news that a brother of one of my classmates also died. He was a patient of mine. Liver failure, because he was an alcoholic. So I see the blessing of life. Life could easily be taken, but we are blessed because we are still alive now. So we appreciate the life that God gives us. So we have to live our life to the fullest. So we appreciate life. Relating to others, So as I've said, we do not quarantine ourselves. We keep physical distance, but we maintain social contact, relate with others, especially the members of our family. And new possibilities in life, this is a time nga daw down ang hotel industry, down ang transportation industry, down ang airline industry, down ang tourism industry. So, you may feel nga, why nagid? But, God will open. When God closes the door, He opens the window. A friend of ours in the U.S. has no job because of the pandemic. So she cannot travel anymore to several hours to her former job kay kalayo na gid. Pero you know what? Jobless siya for during the quarantine, and pag open nakita sa job 15 minutes away lang sa Ilabalay. So si God always provides. So there's new possibilities in life. Personal strength. So this is the time that our faith are tested, and God allows us to grow in this. Spiritual change. May lesson gani para sa aton. So ang lesson is, I think nga pandemic should bring us closer to God. Closer to God. Kasi no kapaabi mapalapit. So this will bring us closer to God, and we evaluate our purpose in life. So tips for healthcare worker: know the signs of burnout. Signs of burnout. So that's why nasiling ko mabakasyon ako, hindi ako mag-clinic kay Pauay man kapoy na. Ang last patient ko kahapon, doon ginhawa ko na lang istorya sa iya kay para matapos na. So create a buddy system. It's good to have a friend. Sa Western Visayas, kin partner sila namon para magbuligay sila, so that they can help each other. So continue to engage in self-care strategies, so I have explained that already. Remind yourself, it is not selfish to take a break. It is not selfish to take a break and to set boundaries. Sometimes we also need to take care of ourselves so that we can help others. Kaya sanab lang, paano ko pamati problema sa isa ka pasyente? Kung gasakit unto ko, kung gasakit ulo ko, paano ko kabulig sa imok akong pamatsyag? So we need to be healthy, in order to be of service to other people. So we keep ourselves healthy so that we can help more people, more patients. Next slide, please. I think this is the last slide. Second to the last. Hope is being able to see the light despite of all the darkness. So there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And beyond the clouds, the sun is still shining. No? So we maintain hope. No? Faith is being sure of what you hope for and certain of what you do not see. No? So let me end with this prayer. Sa akong work as among drug addicts. No? I'm an addiction psychiatrist and I work with a lot of substance abusers. And this is our closing prayer sa amon nga Narcotics Anonymous, Alcoholic Anonymous session. So we say this prayer. No? God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So thank you and pleasant Sabbath.